It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. What Buhari will consider to grant request for Kanu's release? Malami. The Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami's son, says that the President, Major General Muhammadu Buhari, will consider the interest of over 200 million before he grants request for the release of the leader of the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu. Malami spoke on Tuesday as a guest on NTA's Good Morning Nigeria show, monitored by The Punch. At The Punch, had earlier reported that some respected Igbo leaders, led by Minister of Aviation in the First Republic, Chief Umbazuli Kamichi, who visited the president in Aso Rock and requested the unconditional release of the detained secessionist leader. Malami had also, on November 10, 2021, said that a political solution cannot be ruled out to resolve the crisis surrounding the separatist agitations in Nigeria, but later made a U-turn and said that option is not on the table yet, saying that the minister saying that the public interest is against the interest of sectional groups when he refused to assent to the electoral bill, amended bill. Malami said that by the way of general statement, the two issues presented, the issue related to electoral bill and issue related to Kanu and by extension IPOP, what I can tell you for certain is that the decision of the president is based fundamentally and at all times on public interest consideration. In the art of governance and what I have come to learn about the mind and art of President Muhammadu Buhari is to consider the 200 million people as against the limited people.
Kanu stated that the action of the defendant on a solitary confinement is inhumane, degrading, and constitutes a breach of Section 34 of the 1999 Constitution. He wants the courts to declare that the respondent, while carrying out their duties, are to abide by Chapter 4 of the 1999 Constitution. Kanu is praying the courts to declare that he is entitled to the enjoyment of his rights to dignity of human person as enshrined under Section 34 of the 1999 Constitution. He also wants the courts to order the respondents to immediately allow him appoint legal practitioners and medical personnel of his choice from any government hospital to review his health file. Kanu equally wants the courts to direct his movement from solitary confinement to where he would be allowed, to pray and practice his faith unhindered in line with constitutional provisions. And this was the agitation of Nnamdi Kanu, who is at the DSS facility, saying that after the court had said that he be allowed to be in the DSS facility with enough attention and comfortability, and he should be given everything needed there, and says that in the suit filed by his lawyer Maxwell Okwara, says before the High Court that he's still denied of food and medical care, clothes of his choice, and tried to practice his religion. Also saying that Nnamdi Kanu claimed that the doctor that has been attending to him is a quack doctor and not experienced.
After I read the report in Tribune newspaper where the Imo State governor said this, I thought it would be nice to take a look at the present situation of the country to know if Hope Uzodema is right by that statement. Despite COVID-19 pandemic, Nigeria was able to come out of recession. Hope Uzodema believes that Buhari has done well by moving the country out of the recession, despite the COVID-19 pandemic that was ravaging the whole country. But some people will disagree with Uzodema because the cost of living is high, which is a clear sign that people cannot feel the impact of the recession which the country has exited. For example, the cost of cooking gas has tripled and the value of Naira is reducing by day. Also, many Nigerians are beginning to wonder how things will be if the federal government removes subsidy by the middle of next year. In addition, the insecurity in northern Nigeria has made it impossible, for farmers to go to the farm, and the consequence is an increase in food commodities like onion, yam, and tomato. I want to believe that Hope Uzodema made a political statement because ordinary Nigerians who are battling hardship will disagree with him that Nigerians are happy with the president. People are joining the APC. What some people will ask is if joining the APC is a yardstick to measure the rate at which people are happy with the president. Uzodema forgot that ordinary Nigerians who struggle by day after survival and not political power. It is common sense to say that people who join the APC are this time looking ahead of the 2023 general election. While Uzodinma is entitled to his opinion, I doubt if ordinary Nigerians who are complaining of the high cost of living will agree with him that people are happy with President Muhammadu Buhari, and that is why the APC is welcoming new members. This may be outrightly wrong, saying that the people are joining APC because they are happy with President Muhammadu Buhari, looking at the adverse effect of the COVID-19 pandemic and also the clear sign of impact of the recession which the country had just exited, where the cost of food, gas and many others are just so high that Nigerians are beginning to wonder if the federal government, you know, would actually increase yet again, remove yet again the subsidy and the adverse effect on the Nigerian populace.
Next Saturday to witness the presentation of a classic book written by Governor Uzodinma. The book, titled Reflections on the Igbo Question, is a bold attempt to situate the marginalization of Igbo in Project Nigeria and how best to overcome it. In a statement he issued in Owerri on the matter, Commissioner for Information and Strategy, Honorable Declan Emeluba, described the book as the thoughts of the governor on the existential challenges of Igbo in the Nigerian state. According to Emeluba, although Uzodinma is a patriotic Nigerian who believes in the unity of Nigeria, he wants other Nigerians to understand the pains of Igbo with a normal view to addressing the anomalies. Reflections on the Igbo question clearly underlines and projects his thoughts on the existential challenges of Igbo in Project Nigeria, including real and perceived marginalization. Honorable Emeluba said the book also x-rays the denial of justice and equity to Igbo, such that some of them now feel despondent and abandoned. But most importantly, said that the commissioner, the book gives a graphic guidelines on how best to address the vexing issue to enable Igbo have a fair and due share in the Nigerian project. The commissioner disclosed that high-caliber personalities have been invited to the book presentation scheduled for Saturday, December 11, 2021, at Ezeimo Palace, Mbari Street, Owerri, by noon. Describing the book as a must-read for Igbo and their neighbors, Emeluba said that the presentation is part of the elaborate birthday ceremony for the governor the next day. He enjoyed all those who believe in the unity of Nigeria to get a copy of the book as a means of understanding the feeling and expectations of Igbo from the Nigerian project.
Thanks for listening, and that is the news.